I was reading the Wall Street Journal recently, and I have a theme I want to talk about today. I want to talk about cash, and I want to talk about what does Berkshire Hathaway have to do with the Pampered Chef, and it has to do with having cash on hand. Now, most of us, when we're reading the business and finance section of the Wall Street Journal, we're talking about people here that have a lot of cash. But it's interesting the lessons learned by people with a lot of cash. I mean, a lot of cash, like Warren Buffett of Berkshire Hathaway. As of today, this is the Tuesday, March 22nd issue of the Wall Street Journal. Berkshire Hathaway has agreed to buy another insurance company by the name of Alleghany Corporation for about $11.6 billion. That's with a B. In fact, not only are they saying, we want to buy all the stock, but we're going to give you an opportunity to see if you can get a better deal elsewhere because we're willing to buy your stock at its current price plus an extra 25.3% premium above and beyond because we want it. So we are going to pay the price that you and I can purchase their stock for, plus they're willing to go an extra 25.3% above and beyond. Warren Buffett's company, which holds a giant portfolio. In fact, you probably know them for one of the companies that they own, the Geico, the little Geico guy. They also own railroads and energy and consumer businesses. They did not make any large acquisitions during 2021. But they're sitting on a bunch of cash because where do you come up with $11.6 billion to buy an insurance company? You get it because they ended last year cash, as it were, in the bank of $146.7 billion in cash. And the saying goes, if you have cash, opportunities will come your way. Warren Buffett has cash. An opportunity came his way. He wants it as part of his portfolio and is willing to pay an extra 25% above and beyond to be able to get that. Now, what does that have to do with the Pampered Chef? I have never been to a Pampered Chef party in my lifetime. My spouse has, many friends have. These are the kitchen gadget people. What a lot of people don't realize is that the Pampered Chef company is part of their Berkshire Hathaway company. It was actually sold to them some years ago, and I happened to buy this book, and for reference, this book was written by Doris Christopher, and she was the founder of the Pampered Chef. This book has a foreword by Warren Buffett. This was published in 2005. So I'm not going to read you the entire book, but I will say that this whole story began in the summer of 1980 when Doris Christopher was just 35 years of age. I'm going to read from the foreword. And the foreword says the following. The Pampered Chef was founded in 1980 by Doris Christopher, who was 35 years old at the time. She was a suburban former home economics teacher with a husband and two little girls. In fact, this story is amazing. They started it in the basement of their home. To launch the company, she borrowed against her husband's life insurance policy, $3,000. Here's the amazing thing. When she needed cash, she used a whole life insurance policy to borrow against. And Warren Buffett goes on to say it was all the money that was ever injected into the company, the Pampered Chef. working with her husband. They did $50,000 worth of business the very first year. Today, and again, this was 2005. Today, it says the 25th anniversary of the company, the Pampered Chef, has thousands of kitchen consultants serving 12 million customers at 1 million kitchen shows per year. Warren Buffett goes on to say, I would challenge anyone on Wall Street to take $3,000 and to do what Doris Christopher had done. In September of 2002, Doris Christopher, the founder of Pampered Chef, came to me in Omaha about selling her company right on the spot. I knew I wanted the Pampered Chef in the Berkshire Hathaway family, so we immediately made a deal. Curiosity, what was that deal? I did research. This is actually a little bit old. I am going back to 2008. And I actually had a compliance person put this information together. And it came from a annual report from Berkshire Hathaway. Warren seems to have made a great deal when acquiring the Pampered Chef. Remember, $3,000 loan against her husband's life insurance policy. The Pampered Chef, the Fortune article indicates that the Pampered Chef had pre-tax profit margins above 25%. So it looks like the Pampered Chef, and again, this goes back to 2002, Pampered Chef was making $185 million per year pre-tax. Warren Buffett was able to acquire the company for, drum roll please, $900 million. Here's the key that I want you to take away from this. It's about cash. So many people are investing in the stock market, hoping about the ups and the downs, and this is where we're going to be taking our ride on the roller coaster, going up and down, because they believe that that is always where the money is. You got to have cash. You got to have cash in the event of emergencies, because we're all told to have an emergency fund. We recommend 6 months, 9 months, a year worth of income. In case you're out of a job, it makes life a lot easier if you have cash. Now you can choose your next job without feeling the pressure. But more importantly, or as important, what about just having cash for the opportunities that come your way? Berkshire Hathaway did it. According to the Wall Street Journal, they were sitting on $146 billion, giving them an opportunity that when this insurance company came their way, yeah, we've got cash, we can just go and buy it. $11.6 billion. In fact, we'll pay an extra 25% just to be able to have it. Opportunities come your way if you have cash. If you don't have cash, you will watch them march by like a parade. You were not able to participate in. But I'm not Warren Buffett, you might say. You know, neither was Doris. Neither was Doris Christopher. She had cash. She had cash that had accumulated in their family's life insurance. And that $3,000 was the cash that they needed in 1980 to propel her dreams to become the Pampered Chef and to one day sell her company for $900 million. What are you doing to get cash that's safe, sound, and secure, and that will be doing double duty, that in the event something bad happens along the way, because bad things, my experience has been, always happen along the way, by using a permanent life insurance policy, a whole life insurance policy. The cash was there. The death benefit was also there in the event that there was going to be a death before she was able to make her millions. You got to be able to win whether you live or die. Because crap happens. I don't want to be thinking about the crap. I want to be thinking about the opportunity. But if you love your family, and if you care about yourself, you want to make sure that you also have the crap factor taken care of as well. Stop gambling with your money, but make yourself available for opportunities. If you have cash, opportunities will find you. You don't have to look for them, because it changes your way of thinking. It changes your thoughts. It changes your perspective. Where if you have a scarcity mindset, where I'm never going to have enough money, never going to have enough cash, today's the day to start implementing strategies to have the cash, and then the opportunities will find you. And in the event of an emergency, you'll be able to say to yourself, it's not that big of a deal. I'm going to be okay because I did the right things along the way. I discuss this and more in my book, Investments Don't Hug, Embracing the Life Insurance Asset, available on Amazon, Barnes & Nobles, iTunes, Audible. You can find it. Google it. If you want to work with me, want to work with us, our team, nothing happens until it's implemented. Cash does not happen until you have a plan, a strategy of implementation. Today is the day that you can make that happen. More information about me, simply go to our website, investmentsdonthug.com.